Preaching in Nigeria has become big business. And some Christian pastors are among the country's most famous celebrities. I've come to see Dr. Sine Fireman, an up-and-coming preacher who's attempting to break into the big time.
The kind of name to call you an Ohuki.
Today, 2,000 people were at an event Dr. Fireman had billed as the burial of Satan.
Welcome to Perfect Christianity Mission. Where the supernatural is natural, and Jesus is Lord. Amen.
Every Sunday, millions of Nigerians crowd into thousands of competing churches. The event started with worshippers who'd been unsuccessful in life or unlucky in love being invited to come forward. Many Nigerian Christians believe that demons are the root cause of their problems. They come to people like Dr. Fireman to have these demons exorcised.
Lift up your hands. Satan is a liar.
Yes.
Tell him never, never.
Never.
The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
First, he awoke the demons in those who were said to be possessed.
One, take, two, take, three, take, four, take, five, take, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11.
This, I was told, caused the demons to take control of the body.
Today is your day.
From now on, Dr. Fireman could supposedly control the demons and expel them from the person.
Now, on your feet, fast! Now, go. Out! On your back, fast! Flat!
This is an incredible spectacle. At times it's almost humorous, but there are thousands of people in this congregation and not a single one of them is laughing. Everyone takes this deadly seriously.
In the name of Jesus.
Then, sick members of the congregation were asked to come forward for miracle healing. One man told the crowd he was crippled and blind.
In Jesus' name, now stand. Stand. Stop.
Earlier I'd seen the man walking unaided, but no one else mentioned it. Other people were also supposedly healed. I wanted to quiz the sick people about these life-changing events, but none would speak to me. At the close of the event, the crowd swarmed forward and threw money at Dr. Fireman's feet. There was so much cash, it had to be collected in dustbins. As the congregation left, I wanted to know why people were giving so much money to Dr. Fireman. Valerie said those who gave were repaid by God with good fortune. She was one of those whose demons had been exorcised.
I really can't say what was happening most of the time. The only thing I know was I just told God what I wanted at home. I prayed to God and I told him some certain things about my marriage and I just wanted him to deal with some things.
And have you been to other churches that work the same way?
In my former church, we did have this kind of display of power. No, this is spectacular.
With the service over, Dr. Fireman left in his yellow Hummer.
It's
hard to know how to feel about what I've just seen. Everybody in there seems to totally believe what they're told, but from my point of view, people who hobbled in half paralyzed have left in pretty much the same state. The only thing that seems to have changed is that the bag that was completely empty is now full of cash.
In Nigeria, independent churches can be set up by anyone, and most operate outside the main Christian denominations. Some of the biggest churches have grown into international multi-million pound corporations. I wanted to find out more about the business model that makes these organizations so successful. I went to meet Dr. Fireman in his downtown headquarters.
Just turning up at the church offices, and it looks like Dr. Fireman's here, but he's driving a different car this morning.
In the lobby, I recognized one of the women who was said to have been possessed by demons at the service. Her name was Angel, and it turned out she was also Dr. Fireman's receptionist.
Have you recovered? The demons and...
Angel said she had no memory of the exorcism.
But really, it looked intense.
Remember, you can just ask people that was around that day because I wasn't myself.
Upstairs, I found Dr. Fireman having discussions with a publisher about a series of books he wants to print. He told me how he started out in the business of religion.
I started preaching at the age of 7. I started writing articles at the age of 6. I started writing books at the age of 14. I established my first company at the age of 12. When I was 17, I had 5 companies running.
How can a pastor become rich doing God's work?
In the Bible, the Word of God teaches that 1/10 of your income belongs to God.
For Dr. Fireman, the principles of his business are simple. He teaches his worshippers to give him 10% of their income and tells them that his miraculous powers can change their lives.
For example, in the church here, we've had countless dead people who were raised back to life. Many of them confirmed by doctors. Many of them carried from the hospital to the church. In some cases, I had to go to the hospital to pray. We have countless cases.
Dr. Fireman's claims were hard to believe, but he insisted his God-given talents were real and he'd turned them into a successful brand.
Father, we thank you.
He claims that in just 2 years, the Perfect Christianity Ministry has expanded to 40 branches. Dr. Fireman now employs a team of associates to whom he's given the title pastor.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Some individually run the church branches. Today, they're having a strategy meeting on how to market the brand.
God is a game. And you know the funny part of it? The game is very easy. You begin to discover.
He stressed the importance of advertising what their church can do in terms of miracles and healing.
If you cannot make what you have to offer clear enough, people are not going to be enticed. People go to church but they are frustrated. So somebody has to answer their questions. So
he said generating money from the congregation was key to their growth, and that any surplus income would be spent on expanding the church.
It's about all that. It's about whether you know the game.
Watching Dr. Fireman is quite interesting. I'm seeing a whole new side to him here. On Sunday, he was the rock star with his big entrance and his entourage. But today, he's more like a CEO, briefing all the managers in his company on exactly what he expects from them.
One reason for the success of the Perfect Christianity Mission is the cult of personality built up around Dr. Fireman. We followed him to one of his many public engagements. He'd been invited to open a new shopping centre by a member of his congregation.
So everybody, J E S U S.
Jesus!
Here in Nigeria, pastors are big celebrities.
kind of person who you want to associate with when you've got a big event on.
His duties over, firemen and his security details sped off. I stayed behind to speak to the shopping centre owner, Edward Dagogo. I wanted to know why evangelical preachers like firemen are so popular here.
Yeah, fireman is the man that covers Nigeria and the nation. When he speaks, something happens. When he prophesies, something happens.
Have you given a lot of tithes to the church?
I do. And that is why you see some fireman himself today coming to commission this plaza.
I see.
Yes.
So what, 10% of your income goes to Perfect Christian Ministry?
Yeah, Perfect Ministry, yeah.
Excellent. How much is that, roughly?
Well, we're in Nigeria, we are local areas, you know, yeah. Because, you know what I mean?
Yeah. You'd rather keep that close?
Yes.
I see. But 10% of your income is a lot of money.
A lot of money, but then to the Lord's side, it's nothing.
It seems to me that here in Nigeria, being a Christian is very much about making money. Is that the case?
Yeah, you know, this third world country, Nigerians, we are rich and we are poor. You know, so what are we looking for? So many people are looking for miracles, for progress, miracles for prosperity, miracles for breakthrough, then above all, eternity, which everybody is seeking for.
In a country of over 150 million people, 80% live on less than $2 a day. The aspiration for many is to achieve the Nigerian dream, to have and be seen to have come.